the world's two largest economies go head-to-head on trade and at least take the opening moves to what could become a trade war, well, international investors start to get very cautious. Looking at the screen, and I'm seeing a sea of red, except for one. The S&P TSX Composite Index is actually up, but internationally, traders pretty nervous about what we're seeing. Let's try to figure out what's going on and maybe what you should be doing with your money. We're joined now from the TSX by Diana Avigdor, head of trading at Barometer Capital Management. Good to see you again, Diana.
Thank you very much, Greg.
All right, so what should we be doing as investors? No one likes the idea of a global trade war. Not saying that's where we are, but we're definitely firing a lot of shots back and forth. Should we be getting nervous or should we stay in the course in terms of our investments?
Well, Greg, to be fair, these headlines, the headline ping pong on trade has been going on for several weeks now, and markets don't seem to price in any kind of cost around it. Sure, the headlines are very important, and they're very, could be anxiety-inducing as to what it might do to the economy. But really, in terms of the economic data, nothing is showing up as negative as of yet. As a matter of fact, the economic surprise index is just pulled higher from a low of 2 weeks ago. So surely, as the stock market is a forward indicator, it's not pricing in any fear of trade war. Now, to be fair, you also have to make sure that you're actively engaging in choosing sectors and stocks that tend to outperform or are doing well. So I think that going forward in the next couple of quarters, at least, you're going to have active management become very important at the expense of the index, as you're going to have razor-sharp attention into what sectors you want to be invested in.
What sectors do you think in this kind of environment make the most sense for investors looking to preserve capital, hopefully even grow it a little bit?
So domestic sectors tend to do well. Defensive, as a matter of fact, in a rising rate environment are not going to be doing too well. Things that protect your, that are inflation protected, so such as technology. And we have actually started investing in healthcare technology. This plays into the innovation. These are also tech companies, but they're really healthcare. And they play on the whole innovation part, artificial intelligence and that sort of thing. So things that are innovative. And then for the longer term, defense companies, for example, they're sheltered, they're sort of protected, and they also have very long-term contracts. So the variability of revenue tends to be more stable. So you almost sort of barbell your portfolio. But that being said, we at Barometer are active investors, and we increase and decrease our exposure to sectors as often as necessary. We have been pretty stable in our outperformance or outweigh of technology. Consumer discretionary has started peaking up, as the American consumer certainly does seem well off.
Now, we are very close to summer. The dog days of summer is already raging hot right now, but we're not actually in summer yet. But when it comes to trading, we know the volumes start to thin out, volatility can increase. I'm thinking of past summers where the slightest rumblings out of China sent us into tailspins in August. Is this going to be the kind of summer where we really need to take a deep breath because the slightest headline could really send things off the rail, at least temporarily?
It's very, very possible, and you're right, that does happen in the summer. It becomes kind of quiet and volatile. We still have 2 weeks until earnings season, so we'll see what happens there. We expect a good earnings season, and we have OPEC coming up on Friday. In terms of the volatility for the summer and its dependence on headline, certainly we haven't seen that yet. There seems to be money flowing into equity markets that tends to buy the dips. Now, it's going to buy the dip until it won't buy the dip. And, you know, it's possible we get a 2-4% little correction. But generally speaking, from a longer term perspective, from an inflation protection perspective, from an alternatives perspective, equity markets and certain sectors of it certainly are there to protect you against that nudge up in inflation that we've actually seen Fed Chair Powell talk about last week.
Diana, for all the things that are happening in the world right now, I find it interesting that one of the things that keeps you up at night is the Bank of Canada.
I know.
What has you so concerned about them?
I worry about the fact that Canada is a little you know, I don't like to say it, but it's a little bit more challenged in the perspective that there is some risk to our housing market. There is some risk to our consumer. We are a little bit at risk from NAFTA. You know, we have a minimum wage that has gone up a lot, which has rendered certain small businesses, especially in the restaurant sector, a little more vulnerable in their margins. So given all that, we have a Canadian dollar that, you know, is experiencing weakness, whether it's because of itself or because the U.S. dollar is rallying. It really makes our currency with less purchasing power. And to the extent that our Bank of Canada is going to feel like it needs to support our currency for further deterioration, I worry that that increase in rates might be detrimental or negative somewhat at the margin on these issues that I just mentioned as risk.
It's interesting because it doesn't feel like it given all the headlines and the things that we're worried about. But the TSX, we're actually on track now, if we can have another winning day and maybe put some more points on the table, for a record high close. It's not a market that feels like it's in record territory. Is that simply because we'll only end up back where we started in 2018?
You're so right. But we have some new sectors which have not yet trickled into the economy. So the cannabis sector, for example, we have some winners there, and we have some technology names in the Canadian stock market. That's a bit of a winner. We have the energy stocks, which when they do well, they do really well for the Canadian stock market. The Canadian stock market is a less diversified stock market than the economy is for us, as it has big weights in certain major sectors, right?
All right. Lots of fascinating stuff to watch. Thanks for going through it with us, Diana.
Thank you very much for having me.
That was Diana Avigdor, head of trading at Barometer Capital Management.